So I've been a Canva Pro user for a long time, and I wanted to see with the new updates that they've been adding to their video editor, could we edit one of our regular videos and get away with it using Canva Pro? And it's a yes or no. So I want to show and share with you what I tasked my video editor to do, what that Canva video actually looks like, and whether or not I think you can actually get by with using just honestly Canva Pro and all the things that it has to offer without using something like iMovie, Wondershare for More, or any of these other beginner video editing programs that you may be paying a monthly fee for, and you probably could get Canva Pro for free. So before we get over into the regular video edit, just to see what the actual video looked like, we're not going to go through the whole thing because it's like a 4-minute video, but I do want to pick and pull out certain parts and just things that I noticed from what we would usually get in Final Cut Pro 10, which is what we usually use, and then what we can do with Canva Pro. Well, I'm going to link up above where the regular video is, but don't click it because I know how some of y'all are. You leave and then you don't come back. So if you want to go watch that video, watch it after this one. I'll put a link at the end, but we're going to take a look at different parts of the video and then see how that was able to be pulled together in Canva and using the Pro account. So let's take a look. If you're using the Sony ZV-E10 with the kit lens, will you actually get a blurry background with that? Or is it better to use the Sony ZV-1 at the widest angle and that f1.7 coming in handy? Well, we're gonna do a quick comparison just so you can see which one would give you honestly a blurry background. A lot of factors at play here, then obviously the numbers on the front of the lenses. So let's see which one it is. Let me know in the comments before you go any further, which one do you think will give you a blurrier background? The ZV-1, the widest angle, f1.7, or the kit lens, the bigger sensor on the Sony ZV-E10. We're gonna switch from the Sigma 16 so you can find out.
Okay, Paul, so we're about 40 seconds in already in this video, and I thought that was very, very, very well done. So a couple things that I made rules for when editing this video, which is you're not allowed to go in and, you know, add any transitions from Final Cut. You have to use all of the regular transitions in there. They do have a music library that's pulled from Epidemic Sound in Canva Pro, which I think is really neat. But I said go ahead and use Fair Game. We use Upbeat for that. I'll put a link in the description if you want to get a free access to that and test it out. But so I was like, all that regular stuff is free game. So if we go back through here, and it's like the same things that we do in a regular video are here. You got me picking up things, you got stuff on the screen, you have a comment below. So as I'm saying something, to say show spell method, and I'm saying something, showing something, it's on the screen kind of a thing. So we got that going. And then there was a transition right at about the 40 second part. And even then it was like a little small transition there.
On the Sony ZV-E10. We're gonna switch from the Sigma 16 so you can find out. So this question comes in.
And that's pretty close to what we usually use. Just that basic, you know, slide transition there. So, all right, let's go over to Canva and see how he was able to pull this off. All right, so now I can see that this is very reminiscent of how like iMovie looks like initially with just the way that this is. And I think you can probably condense this down a little bit. Yeah. So you could condense that down some or bring this editor back up. All right, so I gave my editor a couple ground rules with this one, which is using the basics in here, the transitions and stuff like that. So all that was fair game. So I can see where a couple transitions were added. So right here, we have a different clip on this one. I'm not sure how this is gonna play with this.
So this question comes in from...
Yeah, it's hard to like get those to play right, but you can kind of see it there. Just a basic slide over. So if you click on any of these, you can add to click the transition or add a page in between here if you need to add in a different segment, which I think is pretty cool that they make it easy. It's one of the things I love about Canva, makes it very easy. A couple things I noticed with this, and I can see he had to do this in layers. You're only getting the one video layer here versus in Final Cut Pro. You're getting multiple layers that can stack on top. Whereas with this one, we only have the audio here. I'm curious what he had to do for the audio, just because it's not a whole lot that you can honestly do with all of this, which kind of sucks. I wish they would use a slightly different interface or allow you to expand this up, just because I can see like you can make some adjustments to the audio and like crossfade that in here, which I see that he did. But otherwise, when you're looking in here, we usually like our start our music off a little bit sooner, but I can just see that's a basic gradual transition there, which is fine. And then the one thing that I noticed with a lot of these is that at the point of transition, the audio clips. And so it's a hard, just a hard noise. If we go back to the regular video over here, then you'll be able to hear it.
If you're using the Sony ZV-E10 with the kit lens, will you actually get...
So right before it cuts over to the blue screen, I want you to listen really closely. I'm actually going to turn the audio up quite a bit. You'll hear just a kind of a cut noise. And that's really harsh audio editing. Not that he does this on his own or whatever, but this is just sometimes an artifact of the editor that I noticed within there. And that's something that if you're going to use this, you need to watch for. So let's take a listen.
Well, we're going to do a quick comparison just so you can see which one would give you honestly.
Hear that pop, just the quick blip.
See which one would give you honestly.
So that is throughout all of the videos, which honestly sucks. So the fact that if he's having to cut in for all of these different segments of the video like normal, then it really blows that if at every cut you're going to have audio artifact, which you can honestly get in any video editor because you're cutting off sound. Literally, it could be the audio, ambient audio of the room and just all this extra other stuff. So that's something that I thought was kind of, you know, like, you know, and it kind of killed the edit for me because I was thinking to publish the video itself and just see if we could get away with it. But I personally was just annoyed by it. I couldn't let it ride. So the other thing that I noticed here is that this video is very well done. This is our basic template blue screen that we use when we're getting ready to just honestly do any kind of a B-roll segments and stuff like that. So that's something that's custom to the brand that we already have. But it was able to use images and upload those, do background removals, all of that stuff, drop shadows even if you want to. You can do all of that stuff in Canva, which honestly cuts down the process considerably if you're going to go into a video edit. The other part that I really, really like is the fact that the comment below statement, like that, the words were actually able to pop up on screen. See if I can get this to play for a second.
Let me know in the comments before you can go any further.
Yeah, it's so hard to like catch that stuff by trying to browse this on the web. It kind of sucks.
Let me know in the comments before you can go any further.
But that's pretty cool. I really, really like that. The vibe of the video is pretty good. Only thing is that there's a couple minor quirks that are different for how we traditionally edit videos in our brand versus what Canva allows us to do, which is we would never have B-roll sitting on a video for like 6 to 10 seconds. That's way too long for you to be looking at the same thing. And then I already know he probably had to pull and open up another something for the audio just because to make that cut from my voice still being underneath the video or maybe even cover the video up with the blue screen background, which is probably what he did. Yep. And so just to cover that image up, which is how in layers editing works anyway, but we would never necessarily leave something on screen that long without cutting to something else because that's just a smidge too long. So when you're watching it in the video, you're just kind of sitting there and it's almost like subconsciously you're waiting for something else to happen, but it kind of doesn't. But that just kind of is a personal preference. Some people do all their videos and they're never on screen at all. But because I am on screen for probably like 80 to 90% of our video footage, unless it's some kind of a something else. And even now with tutorials, it's something else on the screen, but I am still present here. So that's just a brand element that we found to do best with tutorial based content and education based content. So something like this sitting for 6 seconds is far too long in my opinion. But just the transitions I can tell are pretty harsh just compared to what we're used to doing. But was able to pull in just some additional B-roll clips from the ZV-E10 footage. And I'm sure you're just able to pull that video clip in. So anytime you see that play button here, you know it's a regular video clip and you can make some basic edits to this to see how long do you want it of the original video footage here and cut different parts. So I think that's really cool that Canva has. And then too, the other thing, you can always hit Command Z and undo anything that you want, which is just about universal across any Mac. This is what I'm using. So I find that that's really, really interesting. So what are my final thoughts on this Canva editor here? I think it has a lot of good bones to it, a lot of structure. I even think for the average Joe creator that's getting ready to get started with videos and they see that this is available, I think that this is a good start. But I think long term, if they intend for this to be a contender with the likes of an iMovie, especially something like a Filmora or Movavi that I really like, then they need to make a lot of changes really quick. But they do have the Epidemic Sound music that they're bringing in here. So I think we can expect to see quite a bit more here. But I think if you already have an established brand, it may be kind of hard transitioning back to something like this, unfortunately, if you already are, you know, used to using something else. But I do think that this will be something very interesting that we pay attention to moving forward with video editors. However, what did you think? Do you think that this is good enough for your regular video edits, or are you more leaning towards keep using like a regular traditional video editor, like an iMovie, like a Movavi, or like a Final Cut Pro 10 or Adobe Premiere Pro, something like that? So let me know, would you use the traditional something, or would you feel comfortable starting with this? Let me know, would you try this out, or would you keep going with something else? I'm really pleased with the performance of it. I was actually honestly very, very shocked initially going through the whole video and watching it. It's a great piece, but it's not gonna ride over here. So, but if you want to know some of my favorite editing tips, if you're just getting started with video, make sure you click on the video on the screen. And if you want to know some other recording and editing tips, we have actually quite a few on the channel, so click on the other video on the screen as well.